So, in the last class, we were studying about distance formula. In chapter number 7. So today, in the continuation of that, a very good questions I will teach you in exercise 7.1. So let's have a revision. Revision is like this. First, this is a rough figure. Two points. This is x1 and then y1 and then x2 comma y2. And the distance d between these two. So distance d equals to x2 minus x1 to the whole square plus y2 minus y1 to the whole square. This is so this is the normal and this is under root over this one. The question is very good. Question is exercise 7.1, page number 161, question number 7. Very interesting question. Before that, let me have a journey which is started, I think, in class 4th or 5th. What? Whenever the two points are there, one point and after that two points, and you are asked about to find the midpoint of these two points, or when you join by a line the midpoint of this. So at that time what you have done, perpendicular and then bisector, you know, both terms are important. Perpendicular and bisector, both terms are important. It may happen sometimes something is perpendicular but not bisector, sometimes is bisector but not perpendicular, so both should be positive. So let's have a revision. Okay, this question number 7 I will teach you. So I want to prepare a background of this question, perpendicular and bisector. So let me have a revision of this one. So if you have any line segment, this bisector, bi means two part, sector means division, bi means two and sector means division. So we will divide this line segment in two parts, division or parts. And perpendicular, you know, perpendicular means 90 degree, normal, perpendicular means 90 degree. This. So how can we find? So the one method is there. If any two points are there, first draw the line and measure the length of this line segment, measure the length and then divide it by 2, and then again place the scale and get this is the midpoint, the first method. But we will not do here, because suppose we don't have any scale, in spite of that we have to find the midpoint. We don't have a scale, we will not use the scale here. So actually this point, midpoint, will be equidistant from this point and this point, will be equidistant from these both. These are first point and these are second point. So for this, what we do in the your class 4th, 5th, we take this point as a center And at that time, you were taught about take more than half distance. More than half distance. This one. And half means you will not actually measure. Means more than half. This is appears to be less than half. Okay. Means more than half matlab you are free to take any distance. But not less than half. But we don't know the half. So that at that time it was said, okay, approximately, because we have a lot of chance to take. So you may take this one, this one, this one. So let but by idea, you will not take less than half. Why it was said? Okay, let me tell. When we take less than half, means by only guess. So from here we will draw a circle. This actually circle is collection of points which are equidistant, which are equidistant from the center. So this point, means many points are there, many points which are equidistant from this center. Okay, and it was said whatever the distance you will take here, you will take the same distance from here also. So if I draw this type, this one, so this again you have many points on this circle which are equidistant from this point. So from this point you have find this much point. This is also, this is also, this is many points are there. From this point you have find this much point. Actually when we have to do the both point at the same time, means this is the point which is equidistant from this, this, if you will take both at the same time, then what will happen? Means if you want to have a point like this that is equidistant from this point and this point, midpoint. So at that time, but we don't know midpoint. So at that time, if we, because the circles are not intersecting to each other, so we are not getting any common point. Common point means if the two circles, okay, let me do. So this is a different circles. Now we take another one. I don't know which is the half. So by guess only I take, because by guess I have not measured. Oh, this one. Same distance. Oh yeah. Again, these two are different circles. So we are not getting common point. Okay. This point, because this distance and this distance, this means this, let me tell, this is A and this is 1, 2 means B. If we take this point, P1, P1 and this point P2 for the circle. So you know AP1 is equal to BP2. But the whole line is not covered. Actually AP1 is equal to this one, BP2. But AP1 plus BP2 is not equal to AB. Okay, A, we take this point just like R. Okay, Q. This is suppose Q. Q1 and this is Q2. At this time also, AQ1 is equal to BQ2. But again, means when you will add this AP1 plus BP2, means these two addition of these two is equal to less than AB. This is also less than A cube 2, means this is not a half part. We want to have a condition like that. Okay, so now take another radius, somewhat more, because this was the less than half, that why the circulars now cutting. If you will take, so by chance, because you don't know half, if you will take suppose half, okay, I don't know, so I will take more than this one, less than half, no circle cutting, okay, increase the radius. Now do. This is the first. This. So you will say, oh sir, we have got cross point, this one and this one. But this will not work because we need to know P, Q, R. Suppose this will, I will take R1. So B, R2 should be equal. But this is not equal. Means addition. Okay. So I have made this one triangle and the same radius triangle we have to make here also. This one. This all things was taught in class 4th, 5th and 7th, perpendicular bisector. But the concept which is required to build, I am building here. So keep patience. So for these equal radius circles means all these points, this and this, both have same radius. This and this is not same radius. So I'm talking about only same radius. Okay, so same radius, you have not a cut point here and here. Here also other cut point, but not of same radius. We are talking about same radius. So these points are something special. What? If you will go on this circle, all the points will be equal to this. Means, suppose this is the two points, this is I, R, and this is the R2. Q1, Q2 was second number point, PQ, okay. So at this time, I may write AR1 equals to BR1. These two are equal. How these are equal? Because we are taking the same distance, na? Same radius, that was the same radius through which we have made, because this point lies on the both circle, on the third circle here and the third circle here. This distance are equal. Not only this is also equal, this and this. So actually what you have got, do you remember rhombus, this one, this will be equal to this side. And suppose you make another one, this is equal to this and this is also equal, means all the four sides are equal. So here you will get this type of construction, this equal to this, all the four sides are equal because the two circles are crossing to each other. This is the rhombus. Okay, so what about this? If you will draw these two points a line, what will happen? Because with the help of two points we can draw a line. Oh yes, if you draw these two points are very important, this like this and this also. If you will draw these two points, you know this will be the in this term, this will be the diagonal. This has been drawn already, and when you have made it, these are the diagonals of rhombus bisect to each other. Means bisect means this also equal and this equal to this. The bisections all may not be equal, means it may happen these are equal to this, but these all are not equal. But this equal to this and this, both are equal. Diagonals bisect to each other. Because diagonals are unequal, this is more and this is less. Okay, if you increase this point, and take another point here, because this is 90 degree here, this same distance are equal. So if we take another point here, this one and this one. So, you know, if you take this, because this is equal, this is equal, this is perpendicular. So with the help of in class 9th, with the help of congruence triangles, we can prove this is equal, this is equal, this is 90. So side, angle and side, this and this, so this will be also equal. If you take any other points, okay. And similarly, whatever the distance here, this distance here, if we take another equal distance, this, this distance and the same distance here, and when you make it, this is also again a rhombus. Rhombus means this is, because you may check, okay, this distance equal to, oh, this distance equal to this distance equal to this distance, everything, because this is not exactly. So when you will do like this, you can measure. Similarly, this is the first case. If you draw another triangle, another circle of big radius, this was the third radius now, you have got crossing point. Earlier you are not getting any crossing point, okay. So when you take any, I have taken this much or more than half, means you have cut a one point. If you take any distance means you can take this hole also, hold this also, but at this time we will not make the whole circle. We made only, because there is a chance that circles will cut here, so we make only this one arc, that is called arc, perpendicular bisector. We may draw only arc, then you will see, because this distance and this distance are equal, so cutting point is here. This equal means all the points will cut at the same point, this. All the points means if you take any, I have taken this radius and this radius, means everywhere, every times you will get the crossing point on this line, this. If we take more than this, then what will you have? Means this may be the whole circle, but I am not drawn, because I know the crossing point will be here. So that's why we say, just like in this figure, this circle is not this circle, the whole circle is not used here. This circle is no useful, because they are not cutting. So we require only the more than half radius and arc. More than half radius and arc. Take any distance, take, suppose I take more than this and then make an arc. This. This one. All the points will lie on this. This. According to, just like I have told you, for here you may also, if you take this point, this one, and all this, the same distance here, this point what you have taken, this one, nah, this one, if you take the same distance here, because the lines are not straight, because I have drawn by hand, these all are rhombus. So when you make this point, this one, this point, so at a time, that is why we say at a time this point is required, this one. So at a time take only one, more than half, so that you may have a crossing circle, two crossing circles, and you may get a point. Okay, this point is equidistant from this and this, but a point is here, this is equidistant from this and point this. So all these points. This point is just between midpoint of AB. This is called M or N, and this is 90 degrees. So that is why it is called bisector and perpendicular. Bisector means this one, and 90 degree means perpendicular. But all these points are, this point is equidistant from A and from B. But these points also are equidistant from this A and B. I want to tell you the actual question. So this was, you do perpendicular bisector. Means perpendicular bisector, all the points lies on the perpendicular bisectors becomes equidistant from A and B. All the points lies on the bisector. Now the question, suppose I have taught you in this much detail. Now come on, if the same question is asked in a different manner, what the question is, suppose you have given two points, this and this, A and B. Find all the points. I'm not talking about find the midpoint of AB. I'm telling you, find all the points which are equidistant from A and B. All the points which are equidistant from A and B. So that will be, where does they lie? This point, all these points are equidistant from A and B, both. This is also, this is one of the one point. Whenever you may have one point now here, this will be equal to this. So if you have to, it is asked. Now come on the 7.1. This was the concept. And now we will solve the question.